In this section, we are going to quickly set up things so that we'll be able to create channels and sub-channels. So basically, channels are going to be our categories, while the sub-channels are going to be the sub-categories. The very first thing that we want to do is go inside of our routes.php file, which is inside of the routes folder, and then we want to create some routes. So I'm just going to use a route group. So we're going to say route group, and then give it a prefix of slash admin, and then give it a second parameter, which should be a closure. And then inside of the route group, we want to call the add method. So route add. First parameter will be the method, and then the second one will be the path. So this will be slash channel. And then the handler will be the controller that we want to defer to when a user go to slash admin slash channel. So we've not yet created the controller, but we're just going to specify it here. So the namespace will be controllers. And then we want to create a new one called channel controller. And then we want to call a method called show. So I'm going to duplicate this. Then this is going to be a post route. The path is going to be the same. The controller is going to be the same, but the method here should be save. Then I'm going to grab both of these, create a space here and just paste it here. So I'm going to change this to subchannel and also going to change this to subchannel. And the controller should be subchannel controller. All right, that's all we need to do for our routes. The next thing that we want to do now is to create the controllers. So I'm going to open my command line tool. I'm using git bash. And here I'm going to say php legato add a controller. The controller that we want to add, I want to place it inside of a folder called admin. And then I can specify the name. So this will be channel controller. So we have to ensure that the name matches what we specified in our route. So channel controller. Then the next one is going to be the sub channel controller. Right now, if we get back again to our test editor, we should now have a folder here. And then we have two new files, channel controller and then sub channel controller. So we now need to create one more method here, public function save. Going to do the same thing here, public function save. The next thing that we want to do now is come inside of views, which is inside of resources. We want to create a new folder here. Let's just call this admin. So we're going to put our admin stuff inside of here. And then we can now create subfolders inside of the admin folder. So if we want to create a folder for channels, we can just create a subfolder here to put all of the things related to channels. And then inside of the channels folder, we want to create two files. So the first one will be channel.blade.php, while the second one is going to be subchannels.blade.php. And now we can just quickly grab some of the content from inside of the login.blade.php file. So I'm going to grab everything here, then just paste it here. So starting from the title, this is going to be channels. We don't need the recapture for this. We want to set the h2 here to add channel. So we're going to say add channels. Then we're going to leave all of this here. Then we need a form here. So this should go to slash admin slash channel. For this specific form, we just need one input feed. So we're going to delete all this. Then change this to add channel. So this is going to be name. We really don't need a label for this. And then inside of here, this should be name. then this should be channel name. And for the placeholder, we can just use back channel name. So here should actually be name. And then at the bottom, we want to be able to display a list of all the existing channels. So at the top here, we're going to have a form that says add a new channel. And then below that, we have a paginated list of all the existing channels. So we can actually throw that into a table here. So let's create another div. So it's going to follow the exact same size. So this should be LG-8. Then inside of here, we want to also have an H2. So let's take this and then put it here. And then we want to have a table below here. So let's get back to the browser and then go to Bootstrap website. So let's go to get Bootstrap. Okay, so let's go here, documentations, and then let's look for components. So what we need is actually a table. So we can just search here. Then we can grab this specific table. So I want to copy this, then come back to the text editor and then just paste it here. So we don't need all of this. I'm going to just get rid of them. Okay, so we just need one rule here and then we need another rule for the headings. So for us, we're going to have the name of the channel, going to have the slug, and then we're going to show the status. Okay, so now we can try to view this on the browser. Let's come here and say /admin/channel. Then we get an error here. We probably need to dump autoload. So we say composer, dump autoload. Then let's try to reload again. So we get a blank page, which is because inside of the controller, we are actually not doing anything. So right here, we need to show that view. So for now, we're just going to say return view, and then we can pass in the view that we want to return. That would be admin.channels.channel. Right, so you can use a slash here or you can just use the dot notation. So let's do a reload and then we get that specific page. I copied two type of tables from Bootstrap website. So we're going to get rid of one of it. So I need to use the dark class here and then we can delete this first table. So we only need one table. That's good for now. What I want to do before we get to the next lecture where we begin to actually program the functionality to create a channel is to just duplicate the content of channels.wa.php, then bring it here inside of subchannel. So we can change this to subchannels. And here we can say add subchannel. So this is going to post to subchannel, admin/subchannel. Should be subchannel. Then this should be existing subchannels. And we want to do the same thing here. So this should be existing channels. So we can now go once again to the browser and then check for subchannel. So right now there's nothing here because inside of the controller, we are not returning anything. So right here, we are returning something. Let's grab it, then come here, just replace that with sub. And then now we can do a reload again. We should be able to see the page for subchannels. That'll be all for this lecture. In the next lecture, we are now going to begin writing the functionality to actually create a channel and then persist the data inside of our database.